Good morning, children. In this video, we'll take up the next component of the cell, that is cytoplasm. What is cytoplasm? Cytoplasm is a region which is found inside the cell, that is actually within the cell membrane. Let me help you to recollect. In a cell, there is an outer cell wall, especially in plant cell I'm talking about. In a plant cell, there is an outer cell wall, followed by the cell membrane or the plasma membrane, okay, and then you have the cytoplasm in it, okay. The inner region is completely cytoplasm, and within the cytoplasm you have almost centrally placed a nucleus. In a plant cell it is towards one side, not centrally placed, but in an animal it is usually centrally placed nucleus, clear? So the cytoplasm is actually consisting of fluid material. It is fluid and also contains various cell organelles, and it is the functioning of these cell organelles which is helping the entire cell to function. Is that point clear? The cell organelles are enclosed in membranes. Membranes means outer covering. Each organelle will have a membrane. But if it's a prokaryotic cell, remember last video I told you what is prokaryote, which doesn't have a well-developed nucleus. That is, them you call as prokaryotes. They will not have membrane-bound cell organelles. Okay, their organelles will not be having any membranes, but eukaryotic cell will have a organelle having membrane. Is that point clear? Now, in this category, the viruses are very tricky fellow. At present, COVID is going on around, so you know what a virus is and how dangerous it is. Now, the viruses are not belonging to living category as well as non-living. They actually require a host body for their multiplication and growth. Outside the body of the host, they are non-living. So, virus doesn't have any membrane and hence it is not showing any life. So, it will utilize the machinery or the body mechanism of the host to multiply or show its living condition. Clear about it? Okay. So, now after knowing what a cytoplasm is, the next topic would be about the various organelles. So the very first organelle which you come across over here in the cell organelle section, cell organelles means they are components which are found in the cytoplasm. Clear? It is their functioning which is helping the entire cytoplasm to, or its entire cell to function. So in the various organelles which you come across are endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, mitochondria, blastids and vacuoles. So one by one, I'll just give you an idea what it is about. The first one we have is endoplasmic reticulum. In short, it is also called ER. Okay. It looks like membrane-bound tubes and sheets. It is long tube-like structure. Okay. In your text, you are not having any figures as such of organelles separately. So I'll send, as I told you, videos regarding the organelles one by one in the WhatsApp group. So they are looking like long tubes and they form small bag-like structure called the vesicles. Okay. Now depending upon whether the endoplasmic reticulum is having ribosome attached to it or not, there are two different types. One is called RER, the other is SER. RER means rough endoplasmic reticulum. SER means smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough because on the surface there is another organelle called ribosomes which are attached. So it is called RER. There is a roughness created because of the attachment of ribosomes. But in smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this ribosome is not present. So the surface appears quite smooth. So it is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. In this particular section, difference between rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is often asked. So one difference will be the presence of ribosome on ER, that is rough endoplasmic, and absence of ribosome will be SER. The next difference will be, since ribosomes are attached and ribosome is necessary for protein synthesis, so you can say RER is associated with synthesis of protein in the cell. Whereas SER is associated with synthesis of fat molecules or lipids. Clear? So, These are the two basic differences between RER and SER. So, 2-mark question can be asked. Another small question which is asked is this one. What is biogenesis, membrane biogenesis? You find that proteins and lipids are generally utilized in the body for making the cell membrane. Plasma membrane ke baare mein padha tha, it is lipoprotein, isn't it? Lipids and proteins are is present in the plasma membrane. Most of the cell membrane, most of the protein and lipid, they are utilized in forming the cell membrane. And therefore, this phenomenon is called the membrane biogenesis. Genesis stands for formation. Bio stands for life. So, the living membrane is formed by the lipid and the protein. Clear till then? Now, the functions of the endoplasmic reticulum. See, here they have given you a picture of the entire animal cell, but they are not given you the organelle separately. Organelle wise pictures are not there in your text. Functions of the endoplasmic reticulum are, the endoplasmic reticulum is a channel for transporting materials, proteins, especially from cytoplasm to the within the cytoplasm, as well as from cytoplasm to nucleus or nucleus to cytoplasm. So endoplasmic reticulum is a transport system. It will be connecting the nuclear membrane to the plasma membrane. So it will allow the materials to move within the cytoplasm as well as between cytoplasm and nucleus. It is also providing a framework, cytoplasmic framework, okay, for the cell. Endoplasmic reticulum provides cytoplasmic framework for the cell. In the liver cells, this endoplasmic reticulum helps in detoxifying poisons and drugs. Sometimes by mistake or intentionally, if you take up some poison or any drugs are taken up, then your endoplasmic reticulum will play a very important role in detoxifying it. Detoxify means to reduce the poisonous content, to reduce the toxicity of the material. Clear? So that was about the endoplasmic reticulum. The next organelle which we have is Golgi apparatus, found by Camillo Golgi. So the name is given. It is again a system of membrane bound vesicles like the endoplasmic reticulum, but that was tube like, this is sac like. Okay, there the small bag like structure was called vesicles, here it is called cisterns, and they are arranged one above the other. Sac like structures are arranged one above the other. The membranes are connected with the endoplasmic reticulum. Means membranes of the Golgi apparatus is connected with the endoplasmic reticulum. Because its function is, the Golgi apparatus function is, the material which are made in the endoplasmic reticulum is packed and dispatched to the within the cell as well as outside the cell through the Golgi apparatus. See, whatever is prepared in the endoplasmic is then transported or packed and sent by the Golgi apparatus. So, ek transport system ka kaam karta hai. It again functions for storing, modifying and packing products in the vesicles. Whatever contents in the cell are to be made, if it is in excess, it will be stored in the Golgi apparatus. If its contents modification is to be done, the chemical nature is to be changed, it will do so, and then it will pack and send it within the cell or from one cell to the other cell. Complex sugars are also made from simple sugars in this particular organelle. The most important thing is the organelle is responsible for forming another organelle called lysosome. Lysosome is an organelle which is found in the body. That is prepared or that is made from Golgi apparatus. Okay, or Golgi apparatus gives rise to lysosome. So there are 4 points of difference. See, I have put it point wise. So when functions are asked alone, you can write this one. On the other hand, if structure is asked, the structure is this part. So for every organelle, you will have two different answers which is asked. One is structure, the other one is function. If they say short note, you will have to write the entire thing. Otherwise, if structure is asked, only write the structure part. If function is asked, only write the function portion. Is this point clear? The next organelle which we have is the lysosome. Lysosome is having a nickname, you know. It is called the suicidal bag of the body. Yes, it commits suicide. So it is called suicidal bag. because its main function is to keep the cell clean by digesting the foreign material. So if there are any foreign material, any harmful substances which must have entered the cell, then the Golgi apparatus will be digesting it, will be breaking it down, and it will protect the cell from damage. Okay, so therefore it is said to be a suicidal bag. Lysosome, lyse means breaking. It has lytic enzymes, very powerful digestive enzymes are there, that is helping in breaking the material which is harmful to the cell. Now sometimes what happens is, if the germ which has entered, or if the toxic material which has entered is going to cause destruction to the neighboring cells, then what will it do? The cell in which the lysosome is present, it will digest that same cell itself. So it is called suicidal bag. Means the lysosome will break. And if the lysosome breaks, the contents of the lysosome will mix with the cell and the entire cell will be digested. So the cell in which the lysosome is present, it will kill that cell itself. So it is called a suicidal bag. Apart from that, it is having digestive enzymes which is responsible for digestion of the contents which enters into the cell. Clear till then? Next comes mitochondria, a very, very important organelle, nicknamed as powerhouse of the cell. For the running of any cell, for the operation of any cell, for the functioning of any cell, energy is required. That energy is in the form of ATP. ATP is called adenosine triphosphate. So the energy is stored in the form of ATP in the mitochondria. And that is utilized by your body. You normally say, I don't have any energy. What does that mean now? Your mitochondria are having energy packed material in it, ATPs. So whenever you are doing work, you are walking, you are running, you are speaking, isn't it? Even when you are lying down, energy is required. Either in active form or passive form. But that energy comes from the mitochondria. Clear? Its structure is given over here. It is having two membrane coverings, means two layers are there in its covering. The outer membrane is very porous. Porous, I told you, pore word. Yes, small opening. While the inner one is deeply folded. Okay? Means, in case of mitochondria, if I try to show it, mitochondria, it is slightly oblong in shape. This outer region is complete, but the inner region is thrown into folds. Means like this it would be there. It is folded up. Clear? Deeply folded. These folds are having ATP generating materials which are called F1 particles. So for ATP energy to be produced, there are particles which are known as F1 particles. These F1 particles are responsible for generating ATP. Clear till here? The mitochondria's function is, it has its own DNA and ribosomes. So it will be preparing own proteins. Okay. Next you have is plastids. Plastids are present in plant because they are responsible for imparting color as well as for photosynthesis. There are two different types of plastids, chromoplast and leucoplast. Chroma stands for color. Plastids which are responsible for color is chromoplast, and leuco stands for white. So colorless plastids are leucoplasts. The plastids which are colored can be of various colors. But if it is green color, it is called chloroplast. Chloro stands for green. So if the plastid is responsible for green colored pigment, then it is called chloroplast. And that pigment's name is chlorophyll. And you very well know chlorophyll is responsible for photosynthesis. So chloroplast containing chlorophyll is responsible for photosynthesis. That is a colored plastid. Okay. So the food which is synthesized by the colored plastids, that is chlorophyll or chloroplast, the food is synthesized. That food is then stored in the leucoplast. Aayi baat samajh mein? Chloroplast prepares the food in presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll. And that food which is prepared is stored in the leucoplasts, colorless plastids. The chloroplast is also available, is also containing various other colored pigments. Apart from chlorophyll, it will have other colored pigments also. Clear? Leucoplast, as I told you earlier, it will be storing materials in the form of starch, oil or protein. The chloroplast generally is membrane layers. Means there are many membranous materials which are present inside. Actually, details are not given for your syllabus, so we don't go into details about it. But there are small structures which are present inside called the grana, and the region in which it is present is called the stroma. Means that the medium which is present within the chloroplast is called the stroma, and the reaction, the photosynthetic reaction takes place. It starts in the grana. Like mitochondria, plastids also have its own DNA and ribosome, so it will be preparing its own protein. Clear? The next vacuole, in fact, the last vacuole I think, is last organelle which is there is vacuole. Vacuoles are sac-like structures which are storing either solid or liquid material. Okay? In case of plant, it occupies a major portion. See, 90% of the cell is vacuole. Space which is filled with fluid. This vacuole means it's called cell sap. If it's in the fluid form, if the content of the vacuole is fluid, then it is called cell sap. That gives turgidity and rigidity to the cell. Saktupan. So the cells are able to maintain the shape. It is able to withstand the pressure. It is able to stand erect because of the vacuoles which are containing the cell sap. This cell sap is what? It is made up of amino acids, sugar, and various organic acids and proteins. In single-celled organisms like amoeba, the food vacuole contains food items that the amoeba has consumed. There are food vacuoles in case of amoeba. Okay, means the food which is trapped in a small sac-like structure is called a food vacuole that is taken into the body of the amoeba, and after digestion it is then it is in the form of contractile vacuole which is then taken out of the body. So such vacuoles play an important role in amoeba, which is a animal. It also plays an important role in throwing out water. Excess water is thrown out. Expel means to throw out, and waste from the cell. So waste and excess water is thrown out by the vacuole. Clear? So all these organelles can be asked as a short note, or sometimes their structure alone is asked. Sometimes only function is asked. Is that point clear? So see to it that you prepare this particular section very well. Okay? With that, your chapter is over. Is that point clear? So, I am not giving you any questions from this part as I told you. We have only written the scientist's name and contribution from this chapter. Then, I think two answers I gave you in the beginning of this chapter, two blue questions were given. Correct? So, as I told you that you may be asked either function or structure of any organelle. So, therefore, that portion I am not making you write. You have to sit and prepare or sit and go through the complete chapter. In science, always remember reading the chapter, and every sentence can be converted into a question. For example, see over here. What percentage of the cell volume is occupied by the vacuole? So the answer is 50 to 90%. Or which organelle occupies 50 to 90% of the cell volume? So it is vacuole. So if you read the chapter thoroughly, and every question, every line can be converted into a question, if you prepare like that, then your work becomes easy. Otherwise, it will be a little difficult. Okay, so we are finished with the chapter. Thank you.